John, let me go to you first. This whole thing, what exactly did Mitt Romney say here on immigration?
Well, he tried to pin him down four times, and he wouldn't say it. He basically ducked. He believes it appears in what the president did on the merits. He just doesn't like the way he did it. And this is, we saw in his answers kind of the Romney approach, which is to basically point out what the president's done wrong, stay pretty non-specific about what he would do. But in the primaries, he talked about his position on immigration was pretty hardline. He talked about self-deportation, the idea of enforcing the immigration laws so strictly that illegal immigrants would leave the country. He also said that provisions like this might create a magnet that brought in more illegal immigrants. But he's not talking about that kind of thing now. He obviously has admitted privately he has a problem with Hispanics. On other instances, he said he'd sign executive orders to undo Obama works. He wouldn't do that. So he was in his answer being as political as the president was being political in putting this whole thing forward.
What's your take on it, Peggy?
Oh, I think what John says is true. I think there's a bunch of ironies here. One is that in the Bush era and in the Obama era, both administrations kept their immigration bills as big, comprehensive, full of 14 million moving pieces. That's why nothing has moved forward. Nobody wants the whole bill that either side has. In a way, it is good that one part of a bill has been put forward discreetly. Do we think that that the young children of those who came here illegally might be treated in a different manner that makes their lives easier? I think a lot of people would say yes. However, it was so Obama-esque in that he did it in a way that was crassly political, and it's also unclear on whether or not it's wholly legally justified and legally doable. So it's a bit of a mess and a bit of a step forward at the same time.
You know, we have a soundbite here from Marco Rubio. Nora O'Donnell interviewed him this week, and it plays so much to what you just said, Peggy. I want you to listen to this.
Travel, being away from them during the week. I think a lot of people in American politics have benefited, unfortunately, from the heated rhetoric of immigration on both sides of the equation. Because while there are voices on the right that have said things they shouldn't have said, there are plenty of voices on the left that have used this issue as a divisive point. There's a very strong case to be made for the idea that there are some in the Democratic Party that don't want to solve immigration, because to them, having it unsolved is more valuable on the campaign trail.
Well, there you have it, Jan.
Well, I thought what was interesting on this is looking at Romney's answer. One of the things I didn't think he did particularly well, and I'm going to turn a little bit and combine immigration and the economy, is, as John said, and you pressed him four or five times on this, he didn't give us this answer. But then he also didn't pivot back to the economy. Hispanics care about the economy just as much as all Americans do. That is the number one issue in the campaign. And I think he's got to be much clearer about his economic plan and how he's going to change it. The president doesn't want to talk about the economy today. Yeah. Romney's challenge is to keep the focus on today's economy, just like Bill Clinton did very well back in 1992.
Rich?
You know, I expect, obviously, Romney has not stuck on an answer on this yet. I suspect he'll have to say he will repeal this executive action, but he'll endorse basically the Rubio plan, which does it legislatively. I do think there's a danger here of this move by the president seeming overly political, just like his move on gay marriage, because he is on the record in detail saying he does not possess these powers as president of the United States, and all of a sudden his view of that apparently changed because he has to win Colorado. Mm. And the Constitution says the president has to take care that the laws are faithfully executed, exactly so the president doesn't pick and choose. Now, there's some discretion there, but not enough discretion to say in a wholesale manner, we are not going to apply the law to an entire category of people.
But Bob, if this were so popular, so wildly popular with American people, why would he do this on a Friday afternoon? I mean, on Washington, that's when you dump documents. That's when you try to bury the news that you really don't want people to know about a Friday afternoon. It seems to me he's trying to get his base to turn out, just like George W. Bush did in 2004, kind of play it both ways.